Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So we'd like to try something new this week and try a rapid fire segment as part of the news. So basically throwing together very short and quick updates on various topics. So let's jump right into it. So first up, for customers interested in migrating from SAP process orchestration to the SAP integration suite, we wanted to make you aware of an upcoming webinar happening on April 26th, which was announced via a blog post by Robert Kelly. Registration for this webinar can be found in Robert's blog post. In other news, Omar Ghatani has posted a blog post announcing the SAP Integration and Certification Center Partner Meetup, which is taking place on May 3rd in San Francisco. If you're interested in learning more about this meetup, check out Omar's blog post for further details. And finally, if you want to get an idea of what went down at last week's BTPCon in Eisenhagen, Germany, check out DJ's blog post as he gives us some details and shares some pics from the event. And with that, folks, that is your rapid fire news for this week. Links will be in the show notes.
If you've always wanted to explore, learn out, and generally get some actual hands-on experience with the SAP Cloud Identity Services in the comfort of your own personal trial accounts, then I've got some great news for you. By the way, if you're also wondering why SAP Cloud Identity Services is plural, it's because it refers to a group of services. That's identity authentication, identity provisioning, identity directory, and authorization management. The SAP Cloud Identity Services are now available for trial accounts. You can head over to the service marketplace and create a subscription. If you don't see the option, then just head over to the entitlements and add it there. Once you've activated your account, in an email that you'll receive, which also contains a link to your SAP Cloud Identity Services Administration Console, you'll be able to connect up the tenant as a trusted application identity provider to your subaccount. And then it's off to the races. This is a great learning opportunity for all of us. Happy Cloud Identity.
SAP remains fully committed to provide business users the best tools to get their job done. Therefore, we're continuously improving our mobile app portfolio, design system, and mobile technology offerings. Now with SAP Fiori for Android 6.0 and iOS 9.1, we provide the latest enhancements and improvements to our mobile community. Some of the highlights are the data table cards. They can not only be used for displaying data, but also as an entry point to the brand new data table or any other defined data screens. On iOS, we have improved the timeline view with enhanced queues, which display a list of items such as tasks, events, or meetings in a chronological order. Along with the timeline view, we have also visually enhanced and redesigned the timeline preview. Among the before-mentioned controls, there are many more available to you, so make sure to visit blogs.sap.com and read Emil Wouters' latest blog post. Link to the blog post can be found in the description of this video.
A lot of new features became available to fast-track customers with the bi-weekly release of the SAP Analytics Cloud 2023.07. To name just a few, custom widgets can now be hosted on SAP Analytics Cloud tenants instead of external web servers. Ad hoc analysis can now be created based on SAP DataSphere data sources, such as analytical datasets, analytics models, or SAP DataSphere perspectives. New Data Import API allows you to import fact and master data, and as well, Data Change Insights notification subscription automatically detects significant changes to data in a story within a particular period, and can send them to the user's email, system notifications, or the tenant's home screen. All these features will be part of the SAP Analytics Cloud QRC 2 2023 release. But already now, Orla Cullen takes a sneak peek into some of the great new features coming your way this quarter. In her blog post, she shares with you her top 5, which includes the unification of stories and analytic applications into one single artifact based on the optimized stack in SAP Analytics Cloud. To help you with stories design, our colleagues prepared an updated learning journey now available for free on the SAP Learning website. You are welcome as well to join Q&A live sessions with our SAP experts, where you can get answers to your questions about this self-study content. Additionally, you can choose one of many expert deep dive sessions to join. They will cover topics such as the unified story design, preparing data in SAP DataSphere as a source for SAP Analytics Cloud, or securing content and data in SAC. And last but not least, please check some of the cool examples that other developers shared with you on SAP Community. For example, an alternative way to avoid uninitialization in an application designer, predicting League of Legends game outcomes, or bringing ChatGPT in SAP Analytics Cloud using a custom widget.